we're still the same people. That's the issue that we're having today. You so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are the true children of God. Give me Deuteronomy 7 verse 6. Because check this, you as a so-called Native American, right? Has anybody ever told you that you were special above all nations? Did you know that God says that about you? Check this out, read. Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 6. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. So we're a certain type of people. We're a holy people above all nations. Right. Read. The Lord thy God has chosen to be a special people unto himself. So God chose us to be special. You gotta understand, check this, right? We've been taught that the Native Americans were savages, that they had no culture, that they were animals. That's literally written in documents that they felt like the Native Americans were savages and animals. That's why they decided, oh, I could just kill them off whenever we want to.
Right.
We can give them smallpox. We can give them government assistance. Right. We can give them land that is not able to grow crops. Oklahoma's made up of clay. It has, the soil is not fit to grow anything like corn, wheat, things of those natures that the so-called Native Americans needed. You understand what I'm saying? What I'm trying to show you right now is that you're actually an Israelite. You're not a Native American. What happened was, give me verse 64. What happened was the so-called white man came over here just like they did to the Taino Indians in South America and in the islands, and just like they did to the so-called black man from the western coast of Africa, right? They came over and began to give you religion that was contrary to what you had been knowing.
See,
where's it at, right? Check this out. These are so-called Native Americans right here, right?
You see the bottom of their clothes?
On the bottom of their clothes are fringes. Why did they have fringes? Because they were, hold that. The reason why they had fringes on was because they knew they were Israelites.
Right.
When the first explorers, so-called first explorers, were coming over here from Europe, they were meeting Native American people and they were hearing them speak in the Hebrew language.
Bring it out.
Do you understand that? Our people are the original Hebrew Israelites.
That's right.
We're the people that God said would rule over all nations. Now, give me Genesis. Give me that. Give me that. What you got?
I'm
going to
show you something.
This is Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 64.
Uh-huh.
And the Lord shall scatter thee among all people,
uh-huh,
from one end of the earth even into the other.
Because you've heard like stories about like Squanto, people that were taken from here and taken over into Europe. No, it may either be slaves or they were given to priests to indoctrinate them with the Catholic religion and then send them back over here to indoctrinate their brothers. That's what what we're about to read is about to show you. Read.
And there thou shalt serve other God,
uh-huh,
which neither thou nor thy fathers have known.
So the Bible's telling you, bro, that the Israelites, the so-called Native Americans, will begin to serve other gods that they had never known before. I'm going to show you what gods it was. Read.
Even wood and stone.
Even wood and stone. So check this. Come closer real quick. I'm going to show you something. So that wood and stones going into the cross and the cobblestone, they gave our people the so-called Christianity doctrine that white Jesus died on the cross for everybody's sins. But they still put you, and matter of fact, they still put our people, our children, in boarding schools.
Right.
Why? Because the Israelites were the chosen people. That's why they got on fringes.
Right.
The Israelites were the so-called Native Americans back before the white man came and tried to wipe us out. Because remember, it used to be over 500 million Native Americans living in this land. They wiped them out.
Right.
Before they came and did that, we were wearing fringes. Our people,
right,
me and you,
right,
we were wearing fringes. More than likely, we weren't dressed like this. The white man wanted to paint an image that the so-called Native American was a savage. But go back to Deuteronomy 7, I'm going to show you. God didn't call us savages. He called the Israelites a special people. Keep reading.
Bring it out.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 70, verse 6.
Uh-huh.
For thou art in the holy people, unto the Lord thy God.
So we're not savages, read.
The Lord thy God had chosen thee to be a special people.
So we're not animals, we're special and we're holy, read.
Right.
Unto himself,
uh-huh,
above all people.
So that's why the so-called other nations wanted to come in and destroy us. They wanted to take away our heritage. Give me that Jeremiah. Because if they knew if they took away our heritage, they would be able to destroy us as a people. That's why you're not wearing fringes today. Because they taught you, hey, those old customs that we don't like, we want you guys to do what we tell you to do. So you begin to do, they would cut your, the kids in the boarding schools in the Carlisle Institute, they would cut their hair off. They would make them change, they would say, we need you to pick a good Christian name. You can no longer be Running Bear. You can no longer be Swiftfoot. You had to now be John, Mary, and Joseph. Why? Because our names would be changed. It was prophesied that the Israelites would go into slavery and their names would be changed. You got that? Read. Jeremiah. Right. Right, exactly. The Christian names came in and they just, because they wanted to destroy our people's minds. Right? Read. Check this out. Read. Jeremiah chapter 17 and verse 4. Uh-huh. And thou, even thyself, shall discontinue from thine heritage. The reason why we discontinue though from our heritage, give me verse 15 through number 28, 15. This, I'm gonna show you why you no longer, up until this time, you thought that you were just a Native American. The reason why is because we lost our heritage. God said, the black God said that if we didn't keep his laws, you would no longer remember that you were an Israelite from the tribe of Gad. You would think that you're a Native American, a savage, a wagon burner. All the little weird names that they, in negative connotations they try to give to our people, they put that on us because we stopped worshiping the Most High God. We stopped keeping the law, statutes, and commandments. This is what, this Bible is not a white man's book. This Bible is your book to help you learn to stay in line. To help you learn, okay, you know what? Because you might walk away from this and be like, I don't really agree with it, but at the end of the day, you now know you're an Israelite. You now understand that you're not a Native American. You can now go and tell friends and family that you know that, man, we're actually a special people. No, while they got us on these reservations, while our people are in depression, while we're at a very high rate of suicide, it's in the reservations they commit over seven suicide attempts a week in the reservation.
Suicide.
Uh huh. Good. Good. And check this. But now, the reason why you walk by is so that you don't have to do it on your own. The Most High God is sending you the prophets to help you get your life right. You understand? Like, because this Bible, I could try to stop, like, for example, I could try to stop drinking on my own. I can. Like, a lot of people do it. But check this. Because we, as a special people, have curses that apply to us, it don't matter what you do unless you're not, if you're not coming out this Bible. This Bible will teach you to be like, you know what? I don't need to get drunk today because God said not to get drunk today. Not because I don't want to get drunk. It's because I know that if I get drunk, I'm going to be in sin. And if I go in sin, then guess what? My people continue to live in a low state of mind.
That's right.
Right? Read that real quick. Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 15. Uh-huh. It shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, uh-huh, to observe, to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. So the curses that apply to only the Israelites, because if you notice, do you see a whole bunch of white people living on reservations? Do you see Chinese people living on reservations? You see Japanese people living on reservations? No, you only see the Israelites. Why? Because the Bible tells you, bro, that if you didn't keep the laws of God, you would no longer have your heritage.
That's right.
You understand what I'm saying to you? You would be on the low. Look at how we all live. That's what gets me today, is that our people will sit here and say, well, shoot, I don't like Mexicans. I don't like Native Americans. I don't like black people. But then we live in the same condition.
Right.
We are literally sitting over here on this side of the earth in the time that God prophesied, and we are living out these curses,
bro.
We are living out what this Bible said that would happen to us if we were disobedient. Do you have kids? Okay, so with your kids, if you tell them to do something, what do you expect them to do? And if they don't, what do they expect to get? In trouble, right? I'll punish them. Bro, this is what God is doing to our people. He said, hey, do these laws. If you do these laws, you won't get a whooping. But if you don't do these laws, guess what? I'm going to send the so-called white man on horses, the cavalry, the United States cavalry, and he's going to tear y'all up. That's literally what's happening, what happened to our people. Our people have been ravaged. Our women have been raped. Our children have been kidnapped. Why? Because it's our fault. At the end of the day, they're just an instrument. I'm not trying to sit here and just only blame the white man. He's just an instrument used for our destruction.
That's right.
Because God wants you to wake up, bro.
He wants you to sit here and be like, hey, you know what? I'm gonna go sit with these prophets because I need to help them be able to reach people that reach the so-called Native Americans that they won't be able to reach. Because to this day, the so-called Native Americans don't want nothing to do with brown-skinned, nappy-haired people. Thinking that they're better or different than us. Thinking that we're enemies. But we're all in the same freaking boat.
That's right.
We're in the same boat and we have to wake up. If you can wake up right now and you start, like, check this, every Sabbath we should see you right here learning. Every Sabbath, because now you know you're an Israelite.
That's right.
Now you're held accountable.
Right.
Because when the Most High comes back, when Black Christ comes back, and you don't want to keep these laws, you're like, man, remember that dude Enos? I sent him to teach you the word and you didn't want to keep it. I sent him to teach you about fringes and you didn't want to put them on. I sent him to teach you about the Sabbath day, you didn't want to keep it. Then you won't get the kingdom. See, our kingdom that the Most High God is going to give us is going to be free of pain and suffering. There's no longer going to be majority depression in the reservation.
Bring it up.
Because we're going to be ruling in our land. The Gadites, the Benjamites, the Judites. We are the Israelites that are going to be ruling over this world.
Bring it out.
Give me Deuteronomy 28 and verse, give me 48.
Bring it out.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 48.
Uh-huh.
Therefore, thou shalt serve thine enemies, which the Lord shall send against thee, in hunger, and in thirst, and in nakedness.
Right, give me repentance.
So check this, the Bible's telling us that we would be have to, because why? Because the Bible just said that would happen.
Right.
The Bible said that you so-called Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans would go into slavery. You would have to rely on the other nations for your food, for your water, for your clothing, for your housing, for anything. How many, like for example, how many Native Americans do you know that go around giving out loans? None, right? Why? Because we're supposed to rely on our enemy. Why? Because we broke the laws of God.
Right.
Give me that. So I say all that in just to say this. Now that you know that you're an Israelite, right? What are you supposed to do? What do you think you're supposed to do?
Bring it out.
Keep commandments.
Uh-huh.
Right.
That's right. Follow the commandments.
And follow the commandments, right. So that's what we call in the Bible. Give this brother a head clap. Check this. That's what we call in the Bible repentance. And I'm going to show you, because at the end of the day, me and you can scream and yell about the white man, the Asian man, this. We can scream and yell, but if we don't get right,
right.
It don't matter. We just sound like a bunch of angry Black people.
Right.
And we're not that. Like, I might be talking loud to you, but the reason why I'm talking like this is because I love you. Hey, bro, remember, you're an Israelite. You got questions, come and talk to us, all right? First, give me First John real quick first. Because I'm going to show you the reason why I'm talking to you like this. It's not because I have hatred for you. It's not because I don't like you. It's not because I feel it. It's because I love you, and my job is to teach you the commandments according to the Bible. You got that? Read.
This is the book of First John, chapter 5 and verse 3.
Uh-huh.
For this is the love of God.
So if I love God, that means I also love my brother, correct? Read.
That we keep his commandments.
So my job is to teach you the commandments, bro. So go give me what I wanted. Give me that. I'm gonna show you repentance now. And now it's up to you. Now it's up to you if you wanna continue. I know you said you're changing, but now it's gonna be something inside of you. Every time that you're not trying to find out the truth in this Bible, now that you know that the Saturday is the Sabbath day, now that you know you gotta start putting fringes on your clothes, there's gonna be something inside of you that's gonna convict you saying, what are you doing? You'll never be able to get out of these curses unless you start to follow these laws.
Right.
I'm gonna show you this. Read.
This is the book of 1 Kings, chapter 8 and verse 47.
Read.
Yea, if they shall bethink themselves.
So in order to bethink yourself, that means you have to learn about something that you never knew. Something that you never remembered. So our job as Israelites, we're supposed to bethink ourselves. Where?
In the land whither they were carried captives.
Uh-huh.
And repent.
Our job is to remember in America, in Babylon the Great today, that we are the Israelites and we have to repent.
That's right.
We used to scream Black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.